So I think we got about we got to know that we won the national competition only about 3 weeks before the actual event at Cannes. So we were like really excited. We were like running around trying to get our visa sorted and you know getting the money and because we didn't expect to win the national competition also.
I so did.
He did, but
oh wow.
He has his priorities right.
Yes. Okay. So Lakshita, why don't you tell us when you faced this competition in the local level and the international level, what were your main challenges? Now I'm sure that there were many challenges regarding the material and the presentation, like the data, the information, but what are the other practical challenges that you faced?
One of the main challenges for us was finding finances.
Okay.
Because it was 3 years before the international competition that we got to know that we were selected for that.
3 weeks, yeah.
That was one thing, and the second would have been probably, we didn't expect, you know, for things to be that expensive in France.
That okay.
was really expensive, and you know, we couldn't take a taxi even, so we had to walk also. Apart from that, actually, we did really great. We had a very nice time there.
Yeah.
7 days, forums, you know, conferences and all that.
So it was only you two who actually left the country for this?
No.
There were a few other delegates also for like other competitions.
Okay.
And several people representing Sri Lanka, the metal factor and all that.
Yeah,
so
but
they were representing different categories. Like we represented, we participated in the Young Marketers competition, there's Young Media competition.
Ah, right.
And press and there are different categories.
All of them were youth.
Yes.
There were seven people who actually went from Sri Lanka taking part in competitions. Seven young people.
Okay.
And there was few other representatives as well who just participated the event.
Okay.
So about altogether about 10-12 people went from Sri Lanka. Very small team.
Yeah, but I'm sure it was a memorable experience.
Yes,
definitely. Definitely.
Even if you walked and didn't go in the taxi, I'm sure walking had its own little fun, you know.
I think that was the best part about it. The fact that we went through all that trouble and then finally
except
won.
The fact that it was a very hilly area.
Yeah, apartment was like on top of a hill. So every evening we had to like walk back about
one and a half kilometers.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So it feels good. I mean, after you won, I don't think you know you even think about
how she must have felt it better, because one day she had forgotten her pass or something and she had to go back to the apartment.
No, and were you in the heel?
No, I didn't take any heels and go because I knew I'll have to walk, so I didn't, all flats.
Yeah, thank God for that. Okay, but so shifting slightly back to the reason that you actually did this, children's literacy, you said that Room to Read is focusing on the secondary education for young women,
young girls.
So tell us about that. Why did you focus on this kind of project? And was this given to you? Were you actually passionate about doing something about something like this?
Actually, it was given to us because all the participants were given one same presentation, same case study.
Right.
So it was a good opportunity as well for us to like, you know, really think about CSR strategically and how we can fund that. So it really opened up our minds. So it was really amazing. I mean, we went through the whole process of, you know, what kind of a product would actually, you know, go along with the women, because for the company we work for, we have earlier we have never done a particular product specifically targeting the women or the ladies. So we were really cracking our brains, trying to think of, you know, what can we do, how can we actually get a sustainable revenue for this company.
So it
was exciting, and CSR is something that we thought, okay, it was a good opportunity for us also to think and see what we can actually do.
Lakshita?
I'll mention few things that made us win this competition. One thing was the innovativeness of the product.
Okay.
We had to do a lot of brainstorming, and we had several conflicts as well.
I'm sure.
Because she wanted thing and I wanted one thing, and then finally we got something done. That was one thing. And the second thing was the business viability of the project.
Okay.
Because we didn't allocate the full profit for the fund. We actually made it more viable and sustainable and practical from a business sense. That was the second thing. And the third thing, as I mentioned before, also how we faced the Q&A. So in the feedback session, those are the things that was mentioned by the judges.
Yeah.
And it was a fun experience, especially coming up with the idea and selecting the words to be used in the presentation, because that was critical.
Yeah.
And we decided not to use any word. We mostly used images,
right.
full framed images.
And we did
In the presentation also, we wanted to do something innovative. So what we did was, we made all the images before the last slide in black and white.
Okay.
And in the last slide, we said that we really want to make this project successful, and we want to add color and clarity to this project and the lives of these children. And we made it, the animation would come with color and the clarity. And
ooh, so nice. Tactics. That was also one thing
that we were so passionate about what we did. Like, we were very emotional about it. And the judges actually mentioned that all three judges actually had started crying after we did the presentation.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing.
I know. Yeah. We were also shocked when they announced this.
Yeah, because crying after marketing presentation is not very common.
Because we got really passionate, and like, we were really emotional.
You put your heart into
like,
it. Yeah,
we actually put our heart into it, and we said, no, this is how it needs to work, and this, and you know, I mean, it's about a CSR activity also.
Yes,
you know, you need to have some sort of an emotion to
deliver
your idea across.
Very true.
So that was one thing that they mentioned, and we were surprised. We had actually moved them.
Yeah.
Were you planning to be marketers ever since you were kids? So was this like suddenly?
I was. Because
in my case, I didn't.
You want to be a doctor or a lawyer?
No, I always wanted to be an engineer, and I did my degree in engineering, and I was in sales. I was an engineer for 2 years actually after joining this organization, and then I moved into sales and then into marketing. Now marketing, it has been 2.5 years, so I enjoy it. You know, compared to engineering, engineering was also good, but marketing, you know, I got this and
I got this. Yeah, sure. But what I'm saying is, usually when people are passionate about a certain stream, when young people out there, very especially when they're passionate about a certain stream, they're really worried about moving from one genre to another of career. I mean, so what kind of advice can you give them? I mean, if you could jump from engineering to marketing, I'm sure there are so many options out there that people can take.
Yes, my advice would be to, you have to learn about the business. To survive in the corporate world, no matter what field you are in, you have to learn about the business. Especially engineers, most of the time, in most of the companies, engineering is a support function. They don't really drive the business. I always wanted, I'll tell you, I wanted to be a CEO from the day I passed out from the university. From, you know, I wanted to be a CEO. So I knew that being an engineer itself wouldn't help me much to become a CEO in multinational. So I switched into sales, and I got that experience, and I've done finance as well in my education, and then I moved into marketing. So I won't, the advice I would give to everyone is to learn as much as possible about business. So business is what will define the future.
Okay, on that note, we are going to a short commercial break right now. We'll be talking to Hiruni more after the commercial break, so don't go anywhere.
This love only exists in my dreams. Don't wake me up. Too much light in this window. Don't wake me up. Only coffee, no sugar inside my cup. If I wake and you're here still,